And in those days, the Lord spoke to the people of Israel through the mouth of the prophet, and God turned against King Saul. And the Lord spoke to Samuel, saying, Arise, Samuel, fill thine horn with oil, and go up unto Jesse, who is at Bethlehem. For I have seen among his sons the king whom I desire. And Samuel arose and went up to Bethlehem, where David the shepherd was tending his flock and singing in the fields.
God shall be my shepherd kind. He will shield me from the wind. Lead his lamb to pastures cool. Guide me to the quiet pool. He shall be my staff and rod. Restore my spirit again.
Samuel chose David from among his brothers, and he anointed him with a horn of oil. And young David was of beautiful face, and the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon David from that day forward. And behold, Saul assembled the soldiers of Israel against the Philistines in the valley of Terebinth. There went out a champion of the camp of the Philistines, a giant named Goliath. And the giant Goliath defied the army of Israel. But David slew the Philistine with his sling. And the Israelites shouted and pursued the Philistines even unto the gate of Ekron.
David is great, on Philistines on throne, chosen of God is he, suffer and unafraid. So the same is thousands and ten thousands.
Thank you.
house of the king, David met Michal, Saul's daughter, who was promised to whomever should kill the giant Goliath. And Jonathan, Saul's son, made a covenant with David and gave him his robe and his sword. And Michal loved David, and Jonathan smiled on their love. But Saul's heart was tortured by jealousy and suspicion, for Saul was old and David was young. And Saul knew that the heart of the people was with David. One day, while David was singing and playing the harp before the king, the evil spirit came upon Saul, and he took his javelin and sought to smite him to the wall. But David eluded him and escaped. So David took refuge with the prophets in Ramah, and the joy of his youth languished in the hot wind in the desert, because he had bid farewell to Jonathan forever, who loved him as a brother.
Thank you.
and Saul sent messengers to capture David. But when they came to Ramah, they found David in the midst of the prophets prophesying. And they too were taken by the spirit of prophecy and were unable to capture him. David took heart and gathered to himself the outcasts of Israel to fight in the name of the Lord. And the Lord delivered unto David his enemy, King Saul, who was sleeping alone in the midst of the camp. But David struck not at his king, the Lord's anointed. He took the spear and the cruse of water from Saul's pillow, and he went away. None saw him, for they were all asleep. For the Lord had caused a deep slumber to fall upon them.
Mm-hmm.
And war broke out anew between the Philistines and the king of Israel. And Saul's army was in great distress upon the steep hillsides where the heavy chariots of the enemy were mounted, for David was with the Philistines. In vain did the people of Israel call upon the Lord for aid, for the Lord was on the side of David. Desperation sought to interpret the signs, for the Lord answered him not, neither by fire nor by dreams. And his servants said to him, "At Endor, there is a woman who calls up the dead." And Saul disguised himself and went with the two men to the woman by night. And Saul said, "Bring me up him whom I shall name unto you." And the woman answered, "Whom shall I bring up?" And he said, "Bring me up Samuel." Samuel prophesied to Saul that the Lord had taken the kingdom out of his hand and given it to David, because Saul would not obey the voice of the Lord. Moreover, the Lord would deliver Israel into the hand of the Philistines. and Saul fell with his sons on Mount Gilboa. The victory was with the Philistines. The splendor of Israel was extinguished in the dust. And the Amalekite messenger brought to David the crown and bracelet of Saul. But David rent his clothes and wept before his people over Jonathan and Saul, because they were fallen by the sword. David cried, "Gilboa, Gilboa, the beauty of Israel is slain upon thy high places. How are the mighty fallen? Tell it not in Gath, publish it not in the streets of Ascalon, lest the daughters of the Philistines rejoice and triumph, singing and dancing with tambourines. Ye mountains of Gilboa, let there be no dew. Neither let there be rain upon you, nor fields of offerings. For there the shield of the mighty was vilely cast away. Even the shield of Saul, as though he had not been anointed with oil. From the blood of the slain, from the fat of the mighty, the bow of Jonathan turned not back, and the sword of Saul returned not empty. Saul and Jonathan were lovely and pleasant in their lives, and in their death they were not divided. They were swifter than eagles. They were stronger than lions." Ye daughters of Israel, weep over Saul, who clothed you in scarlet and with other delights, who put ornaments of gold upon your apparel. How are the mighty fallen in the midst of battle? Oh, Jonathan, thou wast slain in the high places. I am distressed for thee, my brother Jonathan. Very pleasant hast thou been unto me. Thou hast loved me as thine own soul. Thy love for me was wonderful, passing the love of women. How are the mighty fallen and the weapons of war perished?
Thank you.
Jerusalem, Jerusalem, David is king. He hath chosen thee to cherish the ark of God. And this day the holy ark shall be set up in the midst of Israel. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be lifted up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Open wide ye portals, for the King shall enter in glory. And behold, the shepherds lead their flocks, and the workers in the fields bring their harvest, and the wine from their vineyards, and all the artisans have worked for the glory of God. O Israel, get thee up! Ascend the hill where all the tribes are come to receive the blessing of the Lord Jehovah. Rise and scatter the foe. The ark approaches high on your shoulder as it is borne in the battle. See the singers and the musicians and the women ringing their sistra. And behold, King David dances before the ark, and the earth and the heaven resound beneath the sun like tambourines under the delicate fingers of maidens.
Thank you. Thank you.
David came to the summit of his power, and God blessed him. All the kings of the earth were his allies, and he was king among them. But sin entered into his heart. For he looked from his terrace into the garden of the pomegranates and saw there the peerless beauty of Bathsheba, wife of Uriah the Hittite. And David coveted Bathsheba and took her to wife and had her husband killed in the forefront of the battle. But the wrath of Jehovah fell on the child that Bathsheba bore David, and the child died. And David called upon the Lord in his distress and begged for mercy. And the Lord sent Nathan to reprove the king and queen for their sin, for which a child has died. And behold, what chastisement fell upon the adulterous house. For a brother had ravished a sister, and a brother killed a brother. And Absalom, David's well-beloved son, rose up against his father. David escaped from the city along the road to the desert.
Or shall I raise mine eyes unto the mountains? From whence should come my help? The Lord shall guide thy steps, going and coming. From henceforth evermore. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved, for he is on high watching above. The Lord who is thy king,
the army of Absalom fled, and in the forest of Ephraim, Joab killed Absalom. King wept for his dead son before the victorious army. Warriors of Israel, from this day forward, you are my bones and my flesh. Your king thanks you. You have established peace in Israel. Thank you. his enemies vanquished, David lifted his heart to the Lord in thanksgiving. David waxed old and full in glory in his palace of cedar and gold. And once again his pride moved him, so that he made a count of his people to learn his own strength. And the angel of death struck Jerusalem with his sword of fire. The Lord spared Jerusalem because David had repented, and having promised the Lord to build for him a magnificent house, David saw the accomplishment of the glorious dreams of his youth and of his life. Thank you. And Nathan said, before Israel and before Jehovah, we anoint as king Solomon, the son of David. And all the people shouted, long live Solomon, the king! David said, the Spirit of the Lord speaketh within me. A just one shall appear among men, reigning in the fear of God. He shall come as the light of the morning when the sun ariseth. Oh, how beautiful was my life! I thank thee, God, thou who gavest me this gift.